Good day, ladies and gentlemen. It's me, Adrian, and this is going to be the start of my superhero summer. I'll be reviewing superhero movies, superhero video games, and also be streaming some video games as well. Superhero-based video games, I should say. And I'll be doing this from now all the way up until the end of August. Of course, I'll also be doing some RPGs and other games too, so it's not going to be all superhero stuff, but it'll be a lot of superhero stuff. It's going to be one of my main focuses of this whole summer. And I'm really excited for it. And to start things off, I want to review Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman stars Gal Gadot and Chris Pine. And let me just say, this movie is really awesome. I really enjoyed this movie. It's probably the best DCEU movie so far. Probably it is. Let me say it is the best DCEU movie so far. And hopefully this will be a start of a good streak, because Marvel's head and shoulders ahead of DC right now when it comes to movies, and they really need to start making up some ground, and this is a good start, you know. Hopefully Justice League will do the same thing and just expand from there. But in Wonder Woman, you have Gal Gadot, who plays Diane, aka Wonder Woman, and you have Chris Pine, who plays Steven. The movie is an origin story for Wonder Woman. She starts off as a child growing up on an island full of nothing but women. She wants to train to be a fighter just like the other women, but her mother doesn't want her to train at all because of reasons that I don't want to get into. It'll be a spoiler. However, she does start to train. She trains up into her adulthood, and then coincidentally, Chris Pine's character Steven just so happens to crash land on her island, and of course shenanigans happen, and then we have our movie. Now, what I liked about the movie was the characters. I thought Chris Pine's character, Stephen, was hilarious. He has a lot of charisma. Of course, Chris Pine is a great actor. And I just loved his character. Really great character. Wasn't annoying by any means. Of course, I love his work as Captain Kirk in the Star Trek movie, so I wasn't really concerned about him in this movie at all. As for Gal Gadot as Wonder Woman, I thought she did a wonderful job in this movie. She did great in Batman v Superman. In my opinion, she was the best part of that movie. Remember when she first got casted, I was totally against it because, well, I'd never really heard of her. And plus, from when my friends told me, oh, she's just a model. A lot of people were upset about it, too. They didn't want her in this movie. They didn't want her to be Wonder Woman. And I was one of those people. I wasn't buying it. Then I saw Batman v Superman, and I was proven wrong. But overall, she is great in this movie. As for the action scenes are wonderful. There is a lot of slow-mo, though. I mean, if you're not a big fan of slow motion, then you might not like the action scenes. But, and granted, I'm actually not the biggest fan of slow motion either. But there's a lot of, just the way that, I don't know. I'm able to let it pass in this one because they're so entertaining. The action scenes in this movie were entertaining. Didn't have that shaky cam or none of that nonsense. I could see what was going on. Just a heavy dose of slow-mo. That's the only thing. I didn't know if I was watching Wonder Woman or The Matrix sometimes. As for the effects overall at the end of the day was good. Just a lot of noticeable CGI, though. There are a couple of problems with the effects, though. There are some scenes where I noticed it's just completely fake and it just doesn't blend well. Like, there's a lot of slow-motion scenes or a lot of pause scenes. Where it's like, that doesn't look good. It doesn't ruin the movie for me, but it's just, it is kind of distracting, you know. It's a lot of not so good CGI, but there's some not so good CGI in this movie. But there is some good CGI in here as well. The last battle is very CGI heavy, and overall, I didn't think it was that bad. I thought it was pretty good. Another thing I liked about the movie was the chemistry between Steven and Diane. I thought the chemistry was really good. It worked well with the movie. Diane's fish out of water storyline is hilarious. Steven trying to explain certain things to her. It's your basic fish out of water storyline, but still, it works well within the lines of the movie. And it's something that's missing in the DCEU comedy. There's not a lot of comedy. I mean, well, Suicide Squad does have a lot of comedy, but like Batman v Superman or Man of Steel for that matter, there wasn't a lot of comedy there. And comedy works great in comic book movies. I mean, yeah, it doesn't have to be full-fledged Deadpool or Guardians 2. I'll look at Guardians 2 later on. But it doesn't have to be that. Just some like a little lighthearted banter and whatnot. It works well with comic book movies. You can have your serious moments. You could have your depressing moments, but you know, that's Laughter doesn't hurt, you know, a little laughter here and there's nothing wrong with that. And I like that this movie did that. Overall, I really did enjoy this movie. I could tell they really put their heart into it. I was a little skeptical at first when this movie was announced and I saw a trailer. I was like, well, it looks pretty good, but no, I don't know, we'll see. But the track record of DC movies might not be that great, might be okay, if anything. But this is by far the best DC movie so far. And I mean, yeah, it's not up there with the Dark Knight trilogy or anything like that, but it's the best DCEU movie so far, and I'm very happy that I've seen it. I'm happy that this movie was made. I mean, it's about time we had a Wonder Woman movie. I think if you're a woman, you will enjoy this movie. If you're a man, you will enjoy this movie. If you're a fan of comic books or just a, if you're a fan of movies in general, I think you'll enjoy this movie. Overall, give this movie a B. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that'll do it for my review for Wonder Woman. I hope you enjoyed watching it. The next movie I'm going to review is Spider-Man, the Sam Raimi version. Hopefully this superhero summer works out well. I've been looking forward to doing this for months now, and well, now it's time to get my butt in gear and do it. And I'm starting right now with this. And this will be the first of many superhero reviews. Rather it be movies, video games, and of course, superhero streams as well. Speaking of superhero streams, I'll be streaming this today, Batman Arkham Asylum on the PlayStation 3. Stay tuned for this. I hope you enjoy watching me play this game because this is probably not my favorite superhero game because that would be Arkham City. This is probably my second favorite. Really great game. I enjoy this game. I hope you enjoy watching me play this game. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it from our Wonder Woman review. I hope you enjoyed watching it. This is Agent Chamblee telling you to have a nice day, take care of yourselves, and be safe.